Amen. Why a crowd?
Amen.
Crowd handkerchief, are you handkerchief? For Akuma, I am grateful to the Lord. For Amusepe, hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah, I am.
according to the sinful nature, but according to the Spirit. Because through Christ Jesus, the law of the Spirit of life set me free from the law of sin and death. For what the law was powerless to do in that it was weakened by the sinful nature, God did by sending his Son, his own Son, in the likeness of sinful man to be a sinful offering. And so he condemned sin in sinful man, in order that the righteous requirement of the law might be fully met in us, who do not live according to the sinful nature, but according to the Spirit. Verse 5. Those who live according to the sinful nature have their mind set on what that nature desires. But those who live in accordance with the Spirit have their mind set on what the Spirit desires. The mind of sinful man is death, but the mind controlled by the Spirit is life and peace. The sinful mind is hostile to God. It does not submit to God's law, nor can it do so. Those controlled by the sinful nature cannot please God. We see verse 7 and 8. Now I'm reading the verse 7 and the 8 again. The sinful mind is hostile to God. It does not submit to God's law, nor can it do so. Those controlled by the sinful nature cannot please God. Amen. Amen.
Precious Lord Ministry. Yanka Amen. Amen. I just Mpofrimwa na mete minya ko. Papa chese obaba sraya yi. Entena yafrani mpofrimwa kwantu. Asana urade so obaba no. Nti aya no asisi o mwasi e preko. Sani adabi atrasa mno e ka chere ye no. Amen. Ampa odio se ayo yo onto me maland sa oja na maho na sa obaba shasania ye ho esitie na waba ye die opanye interest na abofran tonofo ebeja platform ni nyina ama no enti yabra me samri na me na odi akoma ba ko honhom ba ko odoba ko ejira ye na so yi na ya fra nyame akoa ye papa sofo kase Abra Abai na Abishraya and Abba Nako Abishraya from Jesus, the true shepherd, Jesus, the true shepherd. Kofu Panyi Pa, na Atabuwei, Yani Amo Abaya, Tesa and Zafuwa. Amen. Yani Amo Abaya, Teno. I'm going to hear the TM, you two say, and I'm going to hear the vampire. Now I can't.
Amen. Please, can we be seated, please?
I need your pants, you wait to me, Atina, I say.
Fawa Kwanse. Yemo Asa.
Yeah.
Dedicate your heart to the Lord. Give the Lord your heart. Dedicate your heart to the Lord this afternoon. As His word is about to come to us. Give your heart to the Lord. Give your heart to the Lord. Our Father, we thank you, we bless you for this deed.
Amen.
We appreciate you for what you have done. Eternal Rock of Ages. What you have done is beyond our understanding. You have proved yourself mighty in our midst. Therefore, we thank you.
Amen.
Our prayer is that as we are about to listen to your word, let your word be in us. Let it take root in us. Germinate, bear fruit, so that people will come and see that indeed we are your children.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord Divine, for this moment. Pray that, Lord, your mighty hand will be upon every single person.
Amen.
At the end of this program, at the end of this service, Father, your will be done.
Amen.
Soak ourselves under your authority. Use us as ever before. Submit ourselves unto you, Lord, as you are about to speak through your servant. Father, take in the flesh out and replace me with the spirit.
Amen.
Speak through me. And your children are ready to hear your words. And we will be the doer of your word. In Jesus' mighty name. Let all the saints say amen.
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 We thank the Lord once again.
For the Yankopon asibie.
And we thank our daddy and mommy.
Your dad, your mommy, and your papa, and so I say.
And all of you.
And then one more hanging on.
Indeed, we are so happy to be here today.
And I say, you are here today.
And I believe the Lord is going to speak to all of us.
Jesus said, "Around there, every kasacha."
Amen.
Amen.
This afternoon, the Lord is going to speak to us on a very, very important topic. I want us to pay attention to this topic and to this message very well. Amen.
Amen.
First of all, we are going to thank the Lord for the prophetic word that came. The Lord loves us so much. It is not everywhere that you hear the voice of the Lord. But we thank the Lord that He loves us. And He has really spoken to us. We will prepare our hearts. The Lord will come and dwell in us. He will come and make His home in us. And everything that we will do will be
over.
So let us prepare our hearts. And the Lord will take absolute control. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 Precious. Amen.
Amen.
Indeed, the Lord is precious. And so you are all precious.
Amen.
Amen. You have been blessed.
Amen.
So blessed.
Amen.
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 And our daddy and our mommy.
Your papa and your mommy.
The Lord bless you.
So.
You see, it is very, very, what do you call it? It is not easy for people to hear the truth nowadays. You will not hear the truth.
You won't turn to no kreno.
Truth is gone. But we thank the Lord that through our daddy and mommy, truth has come. It is not easy to speak the truth. People will hate you. They will insult you. So many things they will say to your life. But if you stay by the truth,
and so say,
you will see the mighty hand of God. Amen.
Amen.
We thank the Lord for our lives.
Said
the
young couple, say, "Am I a brabo?"
Amen.
Amen.
I will not waste my time.
Amen. Say, "Every be brave."
This afternoon, the Lord is going to speak to me and you in a topic.
And then the young couple, person, kasa chere no, and they said,
"Don't be a short-sighted Christian."
That just said, "And yet, O Christ, you near when this one you who no ever ahaya."
Amen.
Amen.
A short-sighted Christian.
O Christo niya na niswa di muna ewo haya.
When the Lord gave me this message, I said.
Ebre nyangu ponde asem we mam ne mekase.
Brethren, this is so serious.
Eye adia eye ehu ehia pa.
Nowadays Christians don't have focus.
That just say enembre ba Christo fo bebre ni ni niswa di.
We think about what we see here now.
They say ye twene de ye hu ni se see.
Don't concern about the future. When it becomes like that, then we are going to be a short-sighted Christian. And eventually we will be blind. That is where we will start saying so many abominable things. Some people will say, if Jesus Christ will be coming 2,000 and over years, he is still not here. Amen.
Amen.
There is no heaven. There is no hell. There is no torment. As soon as we started becoming a short-sighted Christian, then our eyes will be blind. Our focus will be taken away. Satan will take control of our lives. We will see nothing no more. Don't be a short-sighted Christian. Amen.
Amen.
We are going to take our first scripture from the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 3. We are reading from the verse 9 to 11.
Amen.
Can somebody read the tree language for us, please? Very quickly, the tree language. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, from 9 to 11, please.
I said, and for so many, dear Oyo, a Jumano, Enyan. Anka onipari mhunu aduma a onyankopon eye free fitiase kosi awiye no. Amen.
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 Ecclesiastes chapter 3 from 9 to 11, please.
Ecclesiastes eti emiansa chichi mu ensian enkro na kopem duba ko.
Amen. Brethren, the Lord is telling me and you something very important. I'll take the English. The Bible says, what profit has the worker from that in which he labors? I have seen the God-given task with which the sons of men are to be occupied. He has made everything beautiful in its time. Also, he has put eternity in their hearts, except that no one can find out the way.
God does from beginning to end. Amen.
Amen.
This Bible is telling me and you something very important. The Bible says the Lord God has given us everything.
Bible says
that we should occupy here on this earth. We should go to our various works. We will do everything we want to do. Everything was given to us physically. That we would live a life that will benefit ourselves. But there is something the Lord has given to us. And this thing is what we call eternity. And this eternity the Lord gave to me and you in our hands. Meaning that we will remember this always. We should not forget it. Eternity.
Not just a down
error. Any other thing the Lord gave to us. Physically.
Or the share
do whatever you want to do. Do your works. Look after your children. But eternity.
But
where we will spend our eternal life. That God intentionally open our
hearts
and bless it. The reason is this. So that you will not lose it. So that you will keep it forever. So that you will cling to it. So that you will walk by it. No matter what will happen to your life, that eternity should not be taken away. Amen.
Amen.
It has to be part of you. Brethren, God is so wise. A very wise God. He opened your heart.
Open
my heart. Open my heart. And place eternity.
Amen.
But what are we seeing now? So many people are taking this eternity from our heart. And are putting something else. Amen.
Amen.
We should not forget this. Amen.
Amen.
If you are a Christian with a short-sighted life, you will not think about this eternity. Because you see whatever you see here on earth. But you are not thinking about the future. Where the Lord has prepared for you. What the Lord has meant for you. The thing that He wants me and you to acquire. He has put in everything in our hearts. And we have to work for it. Amen.
Amen.
In the first day we had faith. To follow Jesus Christ. Faith is so good. But faith without works is dead.
Amen.
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 So go with me very quickly to the book of 2 Peter chapter
1.
The Lord is going to speak to us what we should add to this faith. In order to see the kingdom of
God.
Glory be to Jesus.
Amen.
2 Peter chapter 1. Amen.
Amen.
2 Peter chapter 1, we are going to read from the verse 2. 2 Peter chapter 1 from 2. Go in.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. May King Kai free Pedro Muma Atosumienu, Eti Edikan, Chichimumienu Elkon. 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 2. Go in.
Amen.
Amen. Or say, Adomine Asumje in Osum Mamun.
Amen.
Yankupone and Eradi Yesu, whom in Dimu. Said the Minyankopon Fema Modin, de Enoma A Fa and Kwa, ni Onyameson Onyameson Pamun yina Achayen, de Onam and Munyam, ne Menier, so Afrayen, hunim die mu ichiche mu nan eno so so na onam achayen boshe a esusu akese akese a ne boye den na se mwanya adwane akono mu pura a ewo wiase a mo afa yere nu so enya yakopon so no bi ye arante na mo so mu mo modi nyina mfa nka ho na mo nchere mu jide no mu meniye ene meniye ne mu nimdie ntete mu nsia ne nimdie no mu enida ho ne enida ho no mu buaseto ne buaseto no mu onyamesompa ne onyamesompa no mu onuado ne onuado no mu odo mapa na se ye no mu wo mu na edo so a ere ma mu nye enihafo ne won a won so aba yen erade yesu kristo hu nim die fem ichiche mu kunu efri se je ye nu abo no no ye onifredi na na ni enyam ihunu echi ade na ne re efri ni boni a waye dada no hu hofo ichiche mu du enti mu enuano mu mo modi nshamu fre nu mu ye den na se mu ye ye nu a mu sintida na sama wabema mu akwan apo so akoyen ewurade ne yen agye nkwa yesu kristo da ahinye nu mu
amen
amen
amen but this is what the Lord is telling us
but of for asema nyame ene ye kan ye
the Bible says
brother I say
let me start from the five because of our time. But also for this very reason, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue. To virtue, knowledge. To knowledge, self-control. To self-control, perseverance. To perseverance, godliness. Amen.
Amen.
Now we have gained the faith.
They say, yes, sir, I can you deal.
To work out our salvation. But the Lord is telling us something so important. As we work diligently, the Bible wants us to add some things to our life. Some attributes to our life. Something that will help us to finish this race. Something that will help us to get to our destination. If these things are not part of our life, then it's going to be very difficult for us to so he says, number one, add virtue
that is a papaya
to your faith.
Faka
add knowledge. To your faith. Add self-control. To your faith. Add perseverance. God is
there.
Amen. To your faith. The Lord is waiting to see all these attributes in our life. If all these things are not in our life, then it is going to be very difficult to go to
heaven.
Our faith will be in vain. Our faith will be nothing. We will do anything that we do here on earth, but we will die and enter into
heaven.
Amen. So the Lord is taking all these attributes added to the effect we have in order for us to move forward. Is the Lord communicating?
Amen.
So he says, godliness and brotherly kindness. And to brotherly kindness, love.
Amen.
Amen. All these things have to be manifest in our life.
That is a sign of
in order to prepare us to enter into the kingdom of
heaven.
Glory be to Jesus.
Amen.
Brother, there are so many Christians nowadays. They have their faith. They call themselves Christians. But these attributes are not in them. And because of this, these Christians are short-sighted Christians.
says Christophe, Omonisade,
they can't see far. They don't know what the Lord has prepared for them. The Lord says, I want to prepare a place for you. And when I am done, I will come and tell you. And when I am
done,
you how are you going to believe this? How are you going to wait for this? If you don't have all these attributes, you are going to be a short sighted. And eventually you will be blind. Because you will be waiting for this promise. And this promise will not come. So what will you do?
Amen.
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 Do you know Apostle Peter was also waiting for rapture? Apostle Paul was waiting for rapture.
Paul, you didn't know.
Rapture didn't come.
That is
so where are they now? If they will not have this attribute,
it is a one year Sunday
morning. And that
would affect them
to think afar,
to
focus far, and
know
that the kingdom is really there.
They
would have died and
entered into heaven.
But now they are in heaven. Because they were not short-sighted Christians.
Amen.
Amen. So many Christians want to enjoy today. No, give it to me. It doesn't work like that. So many people need to suffer. We need to struggle. And we need to make sure that we have a vision.
Amen.
Don't be a short-sighted Christian.
That is a man who gives his own ear,
leading to blindness.
Ah, a dear friend, ever bro.
The time will come, you will say, "Oh, I've waited, and waited, and it's not coming."
Every person that says, "My chain," I said, "It's not chain."
But if you have this attitude,
and so say, "Who was handing my way?"
Attend to that faith.
Ah, the acting here, no.
I'm telling you, wait for him.
But the four, we got chain.
If the Lord speaking to me and you,
and right there, I know what
glory be to Jesus.
Amen.
Let us continue a bit. I love this scripture so much. So he says, for he who lacks these things is short-sighted. If you don't have this in your life,
it never was,
does not matter how faith you have, you are a short-sighted Christian.
Not just
when something small happens to your
Christian,
take your bag and go.
Amen.
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 And you will not know what you are missing. You will not know what you are losing. Glory be to Jesus.
Amen.
So many people run away from churches.
They pray and
because they are so
excited.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Is the Lord communicating to me and
you?
So many people enter into the church because they are seeking for husband and wife.
Amen.
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 So if wife is not coming, husband is not coming, what will happen?
Amen.
Fast.
Amen. Amen.
So many are seeking money. They are seeking jobs.
There's a much.
They want good jobs. If they come to the house of the Lord,
it is a mobile and
2 months to understand this. So that our Christian life, we will take it very seriously by adding all these attributes to our lives. Perseverance. Do we have perseverance? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I always say this. When the Lord called me before, and he used this word, he said, I will bless you. I was very happy. I thought maybe 3 years' time.
You say, I have
my own jet. Amen.
Amen.
Because I had blessings. But little did I know that the Lord was talking about heavenly blessings. I was thinking about worldly blessings. But the Lord was talking about something different. I was a short-sighted Christian
by then.
Amen.
Amen.
Brethren, what is bothering you? Has the Lord promised you something? hold to him that just a prayer we hear, he will do it.
Obey him.
Even if he didn't give it to you here,
he will
be waiting for you in
that just a chair ever soon.
Amen.
Amen.
Is the Lord communicating? Glory be to Jesus. The Bible says, if you lack all these things, then you are a short-sighted Christian. Even to blindness, and has forgotten that he was cleansed from his old sins. When it gets to this point, you will say Jesus Christ didn't even die for you. Blindness has come. You will say that you are not even a sinner. You will start forgetting what the Lord has done in your life. Because now you are blind. Your eyes are instead of with short sight.
Amen.
A short-sighted Christian.
That just said, Christonia, na ni swadi mwewa hai.
Enter not to blindness.
That just said, ende neko, ende frayimu.
When you get to that state,
se unyamba ni frayimu,
you are gone.
That just said, go free Adam Nasi.
Don't worry yourself.
How will be?
Prepare to go to hell.
That just said, you want to
say, because you will never believe anything.
It says, I won't be there any be.
Glory be to Jesus. The Lord want me and you to have all these attributes. To our faith. So that we can stand firm.
So that we can
stand firm. And face anything that comes. No matter what Satan will do to us. No matter what he will do to us. We are still standing. Because we are focused. We know the future.
Amen.
Amen. A Christian who doesn't know the future, you are lost. Yes.
Why?
Because I'm telling you, through the Spirit of the Living God, that freedom that you need, it may not even come. Maybe 1 year it won't come.
Maybe I feel bad.
Maybe you will die in it.
Ube una ekwa sana sanka.
It's not that everyone is going to be free before they die.
No, be an obinya famudi.
So many people are going to suffer till they die.
We pray. Ebe pray and sana mau.
But what will help you to stand?
Again, ene be guama wechina.
Glory be to Jesus.
Amen.
When it gets to that point, your faith is gone.
Because if
do you know faith goes quickly? You don't know faith. It goes quickly. But when you have this attribute to your faith, they are there to help you so that your faith
will
be sure. So he continued to say, the time he says, therefore, brethren, be even more diligent to make your call and election sure. Amen.
Amen.
More diligent.
Not just
to make sure that your call.
And you must say a friend and a media friend.
Has the Lord called
you?
Confirm it. Make it sure. Amen.
Amen.
Be sure that he has called you. When you know this, nothing will move you.
Amen.
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 Glory be to Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. We thank the Lord so much.
Amen.
He says, for if you do these things, you will never stumble. 11. For so an entrance will be supplied to you abundantly.
Amen.
Are you getting that?
Amen.
When you start having all these attributes
to
Heaven will be easy for us. Our shrine, man, a for Amma.
Easy. We will not suffer.
Umre.
The gates of heaven, every single gate will be open.
Not just a Osura appearing in a baby amount.
It will be supplied to you.
Not just a Yadibet Tong.
Abundantly. You will not struggle to go to heaven.
Not just a own.
People will be struggling.
If you move bread,
but you'll be having it very easy.
Not just a
little bit. Because you have this attitude added to your face.
I will come to you.
You are not a short-sighted.
You
know what you want. You know what is waiting for you. This is what was keeping the apostles. So, Apostle Paul did not care. What will you do to me? Is it not
there?
Kill me, I'm going somewhere.
Amen.
Amen. Because they are sure of the calling. They know where they are going. And the Lord has made everything possible for them. Because all these attributes are working in their life. When it comes to self-control, they control themselves. Perseverance. They will wait. Knowledge. They know. Amen.
Amen.
Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So many things they know. And it was helping them.
Brethren,
faith alone cannot finish
the
thing. Faith. It can fail. You don't know that. Your faith can fail you. It will fail. By the time you know, you are backslided already.
I just said,
Amen. Glory be to Jesus Christ. So the Bible says, when we get to this state, then doors will be open for us.
All the 12 gates to heaven. Not just say, you know,
But if you don't have these attributes,
and you say, sir, and you're
even that one door you will struggle.
He says, I'll prove I will cry.
Amen.
Amen.
Because everybody is fighting for that door.
He says, it will be a
pressure. Don't think it is you alone.
We'll freeze our own.
Do you know how many people struggling to enter that door?
But it shall be open. Every door
will be open.
And so you're going to say,
abundantly. And
you'll
be free to enter. In the mighty, powerful name of Jesus.
Amen.
Go with me very quickly. We are coming to an end. Isaiah chapter 51. Isaiah 51, we are reading just the 1 and 2.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Isaiah chapter 51, verse 1 and 2. And now give for Isaiah, my eti, ebunu baako, imu baako enibunu. Making kind of radia sem. A tiffia sem or see on Uncle Pombo Shane and a wretched shred. Or see moon tear me, moa, what did name a chi, Namosha a radino. Monsha or water hour, what pine moon free moon, me a poor hour too, moon free moon. Monsha moon, Edja Abraham, ne Sarah ah, or chum moo mono, sir or ye or barco for Namafreno. Na me shrano, na me mano, na me mano dore. Amen.
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 Isaiah 51, I'm reading 1 and 2. The Bible says, listen to me, you who follow after righteousness. If you are for righteousness, this is your message.
Say, we will be our open train in your
brother. If you are seeking for the Lord,
the Bible
says, you who said the Lord, look to the rock from which you were made. Where you came from. Look back. Where were you before? So many places that we have been. People have lied to us. Preachers have lied to us. So many false preaching. False prophecies.
And come
we have heard everything.
You are telling now.
They have taken all our money.
Oh, my Jesus, you can't.
Do you know by the time you come to know the truth, you don't have money anymore?
But
they have taken everything. I always say that.
Oh, my
holiness. When you come to holiness, you don't have money. Because people have taken them from you. So the Lord is saying, if you are seeking righteousness, if you are seeking holiness, if you want to see the Lord, if you want to go to heaven, then the Bible is saying, think about where you came from. Now where you're
amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
You can find me so for me, but Jimmy, see, can you walk out of
I received 1,000 angels. I was deceived.
But you have
to pay you money that I've received 1,000 angels.
Amen.
Amen.
Think about where you came from. If you get to know where you came from, you will take this scripture seriously. You will know that you have landed at the right place. And nothing can take you
out.
Don't let anyone push you from the house of God. No one. Even if it is you alone, stay here to go to heaven. Stay here. You don't understand. If it is you alone, stay here.
Amen.
Now that when the Lord revealed to us on this Zoom that we worship, about 30, 35 to 40 people. All over the world, when the Lord revealed to us, those who were going to heaven on that Zoom at that period was about 4 people.
Jesus will come.
That's
a Christ to help me by
4.
Nine.
Amen.
Amen.
You don't understand. He says, and to the hole of the pit from which you were dug, where you were picked from.
I
always thank God that I'm part of this ministry.
Amen.
So many people are dead and gone. It wasn't their fault. Ignorance. People have deceived them. But yet God will judge them. We are here, we have life.
And then you will
the Lord has given us this way. What should we do?
People have died. They never saw the
truth.
They've died as well. But still going to hell.
The other time, the Lord, let me say something.
We
that we have seen the truth, the Lord is going to judge just very well.
Harder
than those who didn't know the truth. Do you know that?
Yes.
The judgment, and it is so. Because Jesus has spent on us.
He says, Christo, what be who am I?
He has spent a lot on us.
He said, what
apart from dying for all the world.
Apart from so who am I?
He is still spending on us.
He says, so now,
do you know why? Because some people are dead and gone.
He says,
you are still living. Those people did not know this truth. But you are living.
And so what does
the Lord has not been for us to know the truth. The Lord has blessed you in a ministry that will take you to heaven. What do you want God to do again? The Lord speaks to you in revelations, in dreams, in prophetic
ways.
The Lord has given his preachers who are very hungry but yet preaching the truth. What do you need to do? The Lord is spending on us. So if we could not punishment is going to be higher. Why is it that this tree is not bearing fruit? So that cut it down.
No,
sir. Wait another year. I will fertilize it.
Maybe
it will bear fruit. Do you know you are wasting land? You are wasting land. The Lord is doing everything possible for us to go
there.
If we are not on the right channel, if we will not make up our mind, we are wasting somebody's chance. Amen. You should have gone for somebody to
come.
But you are still there. You are not changing.
What's the sound?
Do you know people who are dying?
With my mom,
going to hell. And you are still in the truth.
That's what
no, you are not ready to change.
Our
judgment is going to be
hard.
It is better we will not know the truth. So the Bible is saying, if you said righteousness, if you said the law, then it's telling you, remember where you came from. Remember where you were dead from. He said, look to Abraham, your father, and to Sarah, who born you. Abraham is your father.
Abraham,
Sarah is your mother.
Sarah,
look at these two couples. They brought forth me and you. But there is something I did. I chose Abraham alone.
And so before Abraham
came, Sarah was not included.
That is a Sarah and come.
Salvation. Individual.
That is a
the Lord has chosen you alone.
If your
husband is not ready,
that is a woman and
proceed. If your wife is not ready, proceed. If your children are not ready,
say your children, for
the other time I told my wife,
tell me
my wife, she wasn't. No one. If I lose heaven, it is my own fault. My children cannot stop me. Do you know why? Wouldn't be extra. Maybe I have a shorter life on earth.
Maybe I have a situation.
And I've been given this privilege. That my son. Maybe a longer life. I will die and go to hell. When I die, that my son will repent.
What we are many years
ago. God will save him.
Many years ago,
are you getting that?
Yes.
I will die and my wife will be there.
That is a me who na me yere gati ase.
And maybe my wife will repent after my death.
That is a me who achi na.
Serious.
That is a me na who amagri.
And I will go to her.
Na me me quote it.
She will repent and move.
That is so onu wasi sa ogwe nyango ponche.
Are you seeing it? So he says, I called Abraham alone.
And you are saying, Chimye me friend.
Even though Sarah was his wife.
Abraham, Sarah,
but I did not call Sarah.
My friend Sarah.
I called Abraham.
My friend Abraham.
And I bless him.
And I'm sure.
And increase him.
And I'm a man.
Brethren, don't be a short-sighted Christian. Focus on the Lord. The Lord has something greater to us. Something in store.
And your was said.
If you have all these attributes,
all
these things are going to be. This afternoon, I want you to know that the Lord loves us so much.
He's spending
more on us. Let us take this advantage.
And what
a salvation! With fear and trembling. Let us go on our feet as we pray.
Amen. Sorry, Adrian. Now, so everybody, go quiet.
Shame, 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 shame
May the
power of the Almighty God touch your heart. Any demon that wants to steal this word away, may the Lord rebuke that demon. That this word will stay in our heart. We will be the doer of the word, not the hearer alone. Our faith will continue to be on Jesus. Our hope will be with
you.
Everything that we need,
He
will provide.
That is obey
Amaya. Open your mouth and dedicate.
You are not voice of
the word of the Lord. May the word of the Lord be sowed in our heart. Grow in our heart. Grow in our heart.
Bless the name of the Lord. Have you noticed that the Lord has
been blessed?
We thought that we were worshiping. We didn't know that we were very short sighted. But this mountain, the Lord has opened our eyes to
Amen.
Bible said the man that whose son took away his wife and went away. Bible said as the man was thinking about his son, Bible said by the time he knew far, he saw his son coming from afar.
I would rather fast out the men,
bless you. God 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 b